Shorty's a tripper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go.
What, man?
Shorty's a tripper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Always asking who was to blame. Never asking, can my niggas be saved?
If the story was about me, I guess I'd tell you about my dad, my real father didn't know. So I was lucky to have the kind of dad with integrity that knew one day that life ill surely would come for me. And they did, his only blood child was alive on the other side of town. It's hard to know how she felt because she hardly came around. Maybe she was mad at her daddy. He's here with me, not with her where he's supposed to be. Feel me? But daddy had a couple secrets of his own. Working up in them schools, couldn't leave those young girls alone. Now the rumors started catching up. What they say, said your child a little something, something. She's in the fifth grade. After job was classic. Used the strength from my mom, but couldn't beat that sexual harassment. I guess it was an addiction of some sort you couldn't shake. That kept coming back, eating food off our plates.
Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow? No. Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow? Yeah, you know. Always asking who was to blame. Never asking, can my niggas be saved?
Now if the story was about me, I guess I tell you about school. I used to go every day. That's what my mom made me do. I gotta admit that I was good at first. In third grade, before you knew it, I became the worst. Who could say I still went every day? But my mind wasn't there. Started falling behind, but really, who fucking cared? Not the teacher, she just wanted the kids to greet her. Say good morning, Mrs. Williams, in the afternoon when you leave her. A real bona fide diva. I failed that year, I should have failed the next, but I would have been bigger than the other kids. All of a sudden, I'm not like all the other kids. My best friend's moving on, I gotta start again. I see school ain't for me, I just let time pass. The teachers never tried to help, they just let me pass. Only a matter of time before I drop out, man. They say they need more money. With a cop out.
Shorty's a trapper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow, you know? Always asking who's to blame. Never asking, can my niggas be saved?
If this story was about me, I guess I'd tell you about Keem. He was the man on the block, the black American dream. Fly leather coats and butter Tims, what he sportin'. Before they even had the streets, he had them Jordans. Remember looking up to him like a big brother. Always had a lot of cash, had to be good with numbers. Never pen and paper. Kept everything in his head, a cherry red Benz with no registration. They say you live by the gun, you gon' die by it. And if you laugh in the hood, you gon' cry by it. A real nigga got killed just the other day. Didn't even make the news, but what could they say? A child hero's gone, somebody talk to him. I could see his soul as it walked through him, telling me to stop, turn around and run away before another kid sings a song another day.
Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow? You know. Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow? You know. Oh, always asking who was to blame. Never asking, can my niggas be safe?
Here we are, another episode of The Artistry Of, featuring Fid and Bo Miles, you motherfuckers. But who are we brought to you by? Well, you know, BoKnowsMusic.com. Go there today and take your music lessons, take your music experience, who you are as a musician, take it to your next level with BoKnowsMusic.com. We're also brought to you by FidLoo.com. Go there, pick up an axe, purchase one today. Find instruments, customize. Some of them are just already just waiting for a home, waiting for you to put your silky hands on them. Get them all hard, ready, thumping, thumping, thumping. If you want to thump, go to fidloo.com and thump. Last but definitely not least, Weebly.com. Go there, start up your website, get your this thing going. You guys and gals have been wanting to do this, but you don't know code. Well, you don't need to know code with Weebly.com. Easy drag and drop templates. Whatever you want to add, you want to do a blog, you want to do a store, you just want to create home videos so everybody can log in and watch little Johnny grow. You can do this with Weebly.com. And now it is time. You know what time it is. You know. Well,
play the music.
Bum, 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 bum.
Let me introduce you to Bo Miles, a unique and likable guy. Everyday life, friends and family makes up the artistry.
Yo, so.
Oh, your light is still on.
I gotta say something, man. And I'm not gonna use profanity today.
All right.
I'm gonna attempt not to.
Okay.
Stacey Dash. She done lost her mind.
I didn't see it, and I hear everybody talking about it, but I don't know what happened. School me.
Now, let me ask you, if I play it for Fox, who's go ape on us?
Hey, well, let's find out, man. Play it.
Okay, let me see if I can find it, man.
Because, I logged into Facebook and I heard people like, yo, you know, this is with Stacey Dash. Like, I just kind of vaguely caught it, you know, so I don't really know what happened. But yeah, man, go ahead and play it. Let me hear it, man. Get caught up with the world. Everyone else is talking about this Stacey Dash issue. Let's listen to it on the cast.
I got a fan in my brother.
All right, yeah, take your time, man. Put the mic down. Go ahead and
it's my mic, man.
Wild Fid is looking for this Stacey Dash clip. Oh, we had the winter storm over here on the East Coast.
Yeah.
And Midwest. So Midwest to East Coast is going crazy with the snow. You know, remind me of my days in Baltimore. What was it? The 96 blizzard? No, it was like 94. No, it had to have been like, we had so many blizzards. I think it was like 92, 3, or 4. You know, we always get hit in Baltimore with the snow. Back then when I was a kid anyway. And that's what we got hit with this time. I mean, snow up to your knees in some places, especially out where I am. Snow was high.
See, only rich people can afford high snow. They don't give us high snow to pull near here.
Yeah, plush snow. I mean, snow just how you just fall out. You just fall into the snow. Got the snowboards out.
Okay, let me see if I got
sliding down the big hills. I mean. Well, my kids, anyway. I didn't.
Okay.
Here you go. Oh, you found it?
Yeah, I got it. I didn't get it off the Facebook. I got it.
It wasn't on YouTube?
Yeah, that's where it's coming from right now.
This morning, there's some growing outrage with some over the lack of diversity in this year's list of Oscar nominees. Filmmaker Spike Lee and actress Jada Pinkett Smith say they're not going to go to the Oscars next month after an all-white list of nominees was announced for the major categories for a second year in a row. Join us now to weigh in, actress and Fox News contributor Stacey Dash. Stacey, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Well, what do you think about this?
I think it's ludicrous.
Why?
Because we have to make up our minds. Either we want to have segregation or integration. And if we don't want segregation, then we need to get rid of channels like BET and the BET Awards and the Image Awards, where you're only awarded if you're black. If it were the other way around, we would be up in arms. It's a double standard.
So you say there shouldn't be a BET channel?
No, I don't think so, no. Just like there shouldn't be a Black History Month. You know, we're Americans, period, that's it.
Are you saying there shouldn't be a Black History Month because there isn't a White History Month?
Exactly.
Al Sharpton has jumped on this boycott bandwagon. He says don't watch because Hollywood... Here's a quote. Hollywood has become like the Rocky Mountains. The higher you get, the whiter.
The whiter you get. Well, that's not necessarily true. And if it is, you know, that needs to change. What I find astounding is that we've had a president who is black in office for the past 8 years, who gets most of his funding from the liberal elite in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
Yet there are not very many roles for people of color. How can that be? And why is it just now being addressed?
I can understand Jada Pinkett Smith's frustration that her husband wasn't nominated for, you know, he did a great job in the movie Concussion.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, what does that say about how people are selected for these awards?
Right. That's assuming they're selected by race, which I think would be a disservice to the people who are looking at the films and making the choices. Maybe they need to be more, you know, integrated and there need to be more diverse people in the process of electing.
In the Academy.
In the Academy.
The demographics of the Academy apparently are secret, but for the most part, according to some investigation out in Hollywood, it's predominantly white males.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah. So maybe that says something about who they select, or are they looking for that, or the best movies and the best actors?
I hope they're looking for the best movies and the best actors. The good news is that there's attention brought to it now. But like I said, over the past 8 years, we've had a president black who gets his funding mainly from Hollywood, the elite liberals.
Yeah.
So it's odd to me that this has now become such an issue.
Well, let's see what happens because they are calling for people not to watch it. Let's see if the ratings go down.
I doubt it.
By the way, before you go, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
It's her birthday today. Right,
thank you.
Shithead. Oops, I blew it already. But now you're here.
Yeah, man, I feel her on some points. I understand what she's saying, far as if we're gonna move forward, then we need to move forward. But
she contradicted herself, man. She said one thing that we should get rid of. If that's the case, then we should get rid of black music. We should get rid of.
But we don't call it black music. Like I see what she's saying is. You know,
if she had intelligence, I would understand what she was saying. But since all she do is video hoes, and she hadn't done anything since her Disney days, I mean, come on.
I mean, I understand, like, when she's saying, okay, if we're going to move forward, we're going to move forward. If we're going to be Americans, then we need to be Americans. But she's neglecting reality. You know, it's not about race. It's not about racism. It's just about hatred and evilness that we have as people, as humans. Like, I was online, and, man, I wish I would have brought my... Man, we're going to have to shoot the next one at my crib, because I got a lot of stuff that I want you to see. And, you know, it's comments like, you know, like, nigger slave, and just all kinds of stuff like that. And it's they're saying this type of stuff because
they can get away with
it. Yeah, because they can get away with it because no one knows who they are. You know, like a lot of the internet hate. Like I got a lot of hate on YouTube, and not from white people, just from blacks. I got a lot of hate from black people. Like black people talk about my hands, talk about my playing. Just, you know, it's people just like to hate online. Like it's not even a color issue, but because when color is introduced, then you get to use words like nigger and whatever else. Like what do they call people? You know, all types of stuff, fag and all type of stuff that they use.
James 3:16.
You know, but that's just in like that's just in us. You know, unfortunately.
James 3:16, you know. Where envy and strife is, there's confusion and every evil at work. That's a catch-all, man. You got haters be hating for no reason. James 3:16. Haters hate because you just got a promotion in your job. James 3:16.
Yeah.
You got an A in your class and they got a B. James 3:16.
And that's just, you know, that's just that chimpness, man, that's still... That we just haven't been able to shake it, man.
Well, the school in out west, they printed the letters on their shirts to form the N-word. Now these are high school kids. So where did they learn that, man?
Yeah, I mean that's just like I said, taunting gays, taunting any. The outside group whenever you can and not really understanding the damage, like not really understanding what you're doing. And that's the thing is like our students, our young people, it's like they really don't have a clue of reality. And that's what I'm seeing. Like even in the classrooms, it's like they really don't have a clue. It's like while the same time that, you know, they have their nigger shirts on, there's girls their age are being raped. Like if they were to walk out in the streets of Syria, you know, in the streets of anywhere in Africa, in some of the countries in Africa, you know, it don't have anything to do with them being white. It's just them having a coochie. And they walk out in the streets like, give me that. At the same time these shirts are printed, they was thinking, hey, you know what we need to do? We need to make some shirts and spell out nigger. At the same time that they have that idea, there are girls their age who want to go to school, who want to learn, who want to get an education but can't because they're being oppressed. Like at the same time that they create this shirt, there are 30 million people in slavery right now. You know, like and people just really don't have a clue, man. Like they really don't. And this illusion of democracy, this illusion of America and freedom, like one day it will be tested thoroughly.
Okay. They claim we don't have anything. We don't have history. So we have to show people we have history. We have to remind each other that we have history. Okay. It's not saying that we're separated from you. You just ain't publishing my history. So you don't consider, you know, it's like a rapist. Talked about rapist. It's like a rapist. They don't want to be reminded of their rapes. They don't want to be accountable for their rapes.
I think they do, man. They do. They want to be reminded. They want to hear it. They can't wait to go to trial to hear the victim tell it.
Okay, so that's what we're doing. That's what BET is doing. That's what Black History Month is doing, reminding you of we are people and what was done to us.
Right.
Okay, that's all it is. It's not saying we want to be separate. It's saying we are somebody.
Yeah, I think people don't really understand. They don't understand like how bad it is. They don't, you know, and it's not because
until they're poor.
It's not because
one of them have a black child.
Right, but it's not because, you know, it's anything malice like, yo, I hate black people or anything. It's not that.
Yes, it is.
Nah, it's not.
They don't even know us.
Right, but see, like, these girls, they don't hate black people. These ones who put the nigger shirts on, they don't hate black people.
Their parents taught them to hate them.
Not even their parents, just the culture. It's just, you can say it. It's just like people with gays, you know? Okay, so you call them fags and stuff like that.
It's okay for cops to kill black guys then. That's basically what you're saying. They don't hate us. They just see somebody want to shoot.
Right, right. They kill people. Like, it's just attention. Like, we're seeing it. We're bringing attention to it now. But the wrong that the cops are doing, they're just doing wrong. Like, it's not because you're black that they're doing wrong. They are wrong. They are evil people. Like, if there were no blacks around, they would be doing evil to white people. Like, they are evil. They are, and it's not even evil. I can't even use the word evil.
So
they are humans.
The cop that they just prosecuted for raping 13 black women.
Yeah.
He did that just because they were women. He chose his victims.
No, him, just like any rapist and any serial killer, like whatever reason they choose their victims or whatever, that's what they choose. There are cops who've raped 13, 14, several white women, several Asian women, several black boys. And, you know, like, who knows what goes into why you want to rape a certain, you know, whatever your fetish is. But he developed his fetish for whatever reason. Now, he was an Asian guy.
No, he
that one who raped the black women.
He's considered Caucasian by his name.
Yeah, I want to say that he looks Asian to me.
He looks Asian. He might be half Asian, but he's going for white.
He said, look, man, I'm representing white.
Look, there are no gray areas. Everybody else is considered white, even the Asians. You can be in the Hells Angels if you're Asian. But you can't be in a black. If you black, you can't be in the Hells Angels. So that's the standard.
Yeah, but see, that's that group, man. Like, all white people are not like that. You know, now, some people who
I never said that.
Right, I'm not saying that you did. I'm just saying that, yeah, like, if that's the standards for that group, just like we have standards in our, whatever group you may be a part of, you know, and if it may exclude other races, you know, then that's what it is. But in actuality, there is no race. Like, there is no, it's only human race. Like, we're all humans, you know? Like, there is no difference other than we're talking about melanin and the texture of our hair. Like, that's really crazy. But the thing is, in this country.
Damn, Bo.
look, man, it's just what it is, man. I'm with her. Like, if we're going to move forward,
okay, be careful. We don't want to lose, you know? We don't want to lose our listeners.
What, man? Like, look, man. I say a lot more offensive stuff, and I'm gonna say more to come. So, like, I just like look. I'm not saying I wouldn't get rid of BET, but at the same time, or Black History Month, but at the same time, you know, that's ultimately where it has to be. If you think about, if you just think, look at the terrorists. I always look at them, and this is going to cause more problems than me saying that Stacey Dash has a point, is when I look at terrorists, and to truly be united, you know, to truly be united in this country, it's both parties have to be ready to dance, you know. One party has to be ready to forget what happened to him, and the other party has to forget what they did to him, you know, like, that's just the reality of it. Yeah, like, that's, because think about it. Think about a million years ago, or we can't even go, let's just go 10,000 years ago.
Let's go to Tulsa, Oklahoma, when they wiped all the black businesses there.
Right, all right. The black Wall Street.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, but see, but that's the thing.
Why did they do that?
That's the thing. Like we said this before, that you cannot, they're not going to give something to you. You have to take it.
But they had it, and they
destroyed
it.
No, like to actually, the Muslim, think about if the terrorists were here and they ran this country. Think about what would happen. What would happen is a lot of us would be dead. A lot of us, the majority of us. Why? Because to take something is to take something. To sit there and like, okay, guys, accept me. That's one thing, but to take it is to take it, you know? If the Muslims, if those terrorists who are trying to, you know, do whatever, if they had their way, all of us would be dead. All Americans would be dead. And once we get onto a very small number, okay, now, you know, all right, who want to suck some cock? You feel me? Like, okay, now that we're down, because you always at, what, 200, 300 million, Okay, now that we're down to maybe 30,000, maybe a million, okay, who want to suck some cock? Like, who want to be a slave? But you're not going to get that luxury at those high numbers. That means, I promise, man, like, I don't even need to talk to them. I know that if they were, if they had their way, a lot of us would be dead. And my point with that is that if we as black people truly, truly wanted to, look, this is my land, this is my country now, you know, then that's what we would be facing. But we don't want to do that. We don't want to kill 200-something million people. We don't want to do that. Only thing we want to do is to be accepted. Only thing we want to do is just to be.
No, we don't even want to be
accepted.
Yeah,
we do.
No, all we want is an opportunity to succeed in life.
To succeed in their game.
No, it don't have to be their game. Just succeed.
But see, if it's not their game, who, like, this country is their game.
No. You see, they don't have ownership of it. That's the mistake everybody keeps making. They don't have ownership. They stole it. They took it.
Yeah, exactly. They took it.
So, just, okay.
They took it.
Okay, give me your watch. Give me your watch.
They took it.
Give me your watch.
My point,
I'm going to take your watch. Is it mine now? No.
But once I'm dead, yes, it is yours. It is yours.
No. It's still, your family have a right to it.
Like, think about that. They came over here, right? This place was populated with the natives. And now look at it. You got to go to the zoo to see them.
Okay.
You know, like, and if the extremists, because not all Muslims, you know, I'm not saying that all Muslims are like this. But if the extremists had their way, it would be the same way. They would come here, and the only way you would see whites and blacks that are, you know, Christians, you would have to go to the zoo. We'd be wiped out, you know. It'd be small numbers to be ready to suck cock, you know. But
no. Those days is long gone, man.
Those days of what?
People having to bow down.
When you want to play chess, you can't just move the pieces whatever way you want to move them. So, when you want to play chess, you have to move and play the way that whoever created the game established it and those who modified it. So,
no, because, see, they change the rules to fit their needs.
Like, me and you or any white person cannot just play the game and be like, nah,
no,
we get to move this.
No,
I'm going to move this this way.
Okay, here are the rules. It's the judicial system, but we're held at a different standard. Okay? They made, because blacks frequent rock cocaine more than whites did, they made it a heavy felony, whereas whites preferred the natural powder, and the time was less given to them.
Right.
That's what you call not making the playing field level.
Right. And there's only, but see, that's the thing. You're still, if you don't like the game, you can create a new game. Now, in order to create this new game, then we're talking about with America, like there was a game already on this country, you know? Like, there was already, the natives already had a game.
Not really. They was fighting among each other, ripping each other's hearts out and all that kind of shit, doing cannibalistic shit.
Right. But they had a system, you know? Like, they had a way of doing things, you know? And
they were oppressing weaker people too. So
right, but see, I'm not trying to say that they were, you know, peaceful by any means, but they had a game, you know. But once the Europeans came over here, it was like, yo, look, man, now it's my game. Like, it's my game, and the only way that was possible was by clearing the board.
They didn't clear the board.
They did, man.
You know what happened? They caught their diseases, man. They didn't have immunity to certain diseases. Elsewise, they would have wiped them out.
All right, but they wasn't trying to save them.
They was trying to get their gold.
No, the Europeans were not trying to save the natives.
The Europeans were trying to get the natives' gold.
They was trying to kill them.
They're trying to get their gold.
Like that walk, the walk of tears, you know, from like the east coast, and they had to, you know, walk to Oklahoma.
That was after the Civil War, man.
Right? They had that. They were already established here then. They was giving them blankets.
With smallpox.
Yeah, yeah, like they was trying to kill them. So it's not like they came over here to love them and then they, you know, my bad. It was collateral damage. Like, no, like they was trying to kill them.
They was trying to kill us too.
Right. But they was, no, not like that.
Well.
Because this wasn't our land.
No, here. The reason they didn't kill you like they did the Native Americans, because you was profitable to them. The Native Americans wouldn't work for them. They either run off or die. We was like, okay. But where could we go? See, this was their country. They can go blend in. They can go with another tribe. Is that my Indian over there? Is that my Indian over there? No. No, man. I don't know what you're talking about, man. Don't run up in here. Well, where could a black go?
Right, right. I mean,
every black was potentially considered a slave. And you had to prove that you was a free man if you was free. And some of them entrepreneurial whites, they clunk you upside your head and put you back in slavery anyway.
Right.
So.
Yeah, I'm not saying that any of that stuff did not happen. I'm not saying that.
But just forget about it, right? Put it behind me and forget about it.
If we truly want to be accepted and to truly be, you know, to wear color and and all of that stuff is no issue,
so then
that would be the point.
Who should make the first move?
This is an evolution thing that's going to take
thousands of years. At some point, someone has to say, I'm sorry.
No. You don't have to say I'm sorry.
Okay.
Think about the Africans who gave us away. They're not apologizing. No one apologizes. The people that as a kid, we beat up. Like, we don't apologize to them. Look, man.
That's why you're going to hell.
Life happened to you.
That's why you're going to hell.
Life happened to you. Life happened to us.
Every one of them kids you beat up, Bo.
I'm going to see them.
You're going to see them.
Yeah.
They're going to be in your dreams, man.
They not. Because they not innocent. Nobody innocent. I thought about that. There was one guy, Squeegee Boy. I hit him in the market. He was my friend. They was like, man, hit him. Hit him. Right? Squeegee Boy, he never did nothing to me. Never did anything to me. You right? So I hit him. And for the longest time, I felt bad about it. For the longest time, man. I wish I could have took it back. But then you know what, man? You can't take it back. Because Squeegee Boy is not innocent. Like, he hit somebody. He didn't hurt somebody. And what happened to him, happened to him. And that's just like me. Whatever happened to me. Like, it's no innocent. Like, nobody's innocent. We all have that sin in us. All of born with it. You know? Like, that's why Jesus came. That's why he died for us. That's why he was the only one that's born without sin. Because it's in us. It's in us.
So you're saying do unto others before they do unto you. Is that what you're saying?
No, I just say my saying is life. You know how they say what goes around comes around. What goes around goes around. Like, people who get shot and like, all of the countless people that I know who right now, who I grew up with, who are either dead or in jail, like, I'm no more different than them. No more different. Like, I'm not smarter. I'm not anything more than what they could have been. They just so happen to be in jail. They just so happen to be dead. And because you go to jail, when you come out, you got that stigmatism on you, you know, like, and that's just what it is. Does everyone who go to jail, are they dimmed to, you know, just a horrible life? No, there are people who go to jail and make, you know, come out and become lawyers, right? It's the same way that.
Not if you got a felony, buddy.
Well, you know, there's a dude, they had him on NPR. He was locked up for maybe killing or doing something. I'm sure he got a felon. And he's going to, he's trying to become a lawyer. You know, like, there's always something, you know, and my point is that just what goes around, man. Like, it's no that you deserved it. Like, you think about the kids who get raped.
So you just saying shit happens.
Right, man, those kids ain't do nothing to deserve a dick up their ass. None of them. And I'm talking about kids right now who are being raped by their uncle, by their dad, by their whoever. Right? Girls being raped by whoever. Like, they didn't do anything to nobody. But it's happening. Why? Because it just goes around. Maybe somebody raped their raper. All right, they're rapists. Man, people get raped and they don't go out and rape. So, look, I'm not trying to hear that. What goes around goes around. Like you said, stuff happens, you know. It is what it is, man. You just got to keep moving. You got to move on. And I would think 1,000 years from now, if we're all like, look, we are Americans in the Star Trek sense. You know how, like, they got all different types of crazy-looking people, and it's like, look, they're all a part of the Starfleet, you know? But we don't question their story. We don't question how they got a part of this, you know, star unit. We don't question that. We just, hey, man, you look weird, you know? But, hey, I mean, if you're a part, you're an ally, you're an ally. I'm not even worried about your story. If we want to get to that point, only way is going to be the same way when we look at Star Trek and you see all those crazy looking creatures. You don't care about their story. You don't know their story, and you're never going to know their story. You're never going to know how they were in bondage. You're never going to know how the Starfleet actually used to cook them up. You feel me? Like, you're never going to know that. You're just like, ah, they're helping out now. You know, like.
I don't know. I guess I'm a little older. I see things a lot different. And then from the young crowd, it's okay, man.
Nah, man, you see the truth, you know, like you see the truth. You see the truth of people, you know, like that's the thing, man. I was thinking about that, like my daughter, like she's not afraid of people, but she's afraid of like animals. Like if it's a cat, and the cat is, you know, jumping or prancing or something, mm-hmm. Oh, then she's a little afraid. If it's a dog. Or a spider or a snake. Like people, there's people out there who are afraid of those type of creatures. But like the real thing that you need to be afraid of is people. You know, like that little sweet, pretty little girl or that cute little boy. Like that's what you need to be afraid of. And that's the thing. It's like because you didn't get a chance to get spanked by them, because you didn't get a chance to get hurt by them, you don't fear them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just like us. Okay. Me and Stacey Dash, you know, like, because we...
Okay, so y'all that crack baby generation.
Yeah. call it what you want. You know? But we didn't get a chance to see it, you know?
Because I'm... Dude. So, let me get this straight. BET is disruptive to unification. Is that what you're saying? So, if the name,
not the programming, but the name.
Well, you know who owned BET? It's not owned by Johnson Products anymore. It's owned by a white conglomerate now.
Right.
So, back when MTV came out, black entertainers weren't allowed to perform until Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson's like, you know, if you ain't playing my music, you ain't in. So they had to do Michael Jackson. And once they did Michael Jackson, they did everybody else. But that type of behavior is what was the spawn of BET. You know, if I spit on you, you're going to respond. Okay? You just not going to take it. And, you know, for every action, there's an opposite and equal reaction. I'm going physics on you. So the hate that hate creates, you know, we black people can't be prejudiced. How can we be prejudiced? We don't have power.
Well, it's not prejudice. It's just hatred. It's just in us. Same way those black guys spewed hate at me. It's the same way white people spew hate at me. It's the same. Like, it has nothing to do with color. It's just in your human chimp nature. That's all it is. Like, it's just in us. We love it. And the longer that we pretend that we don't, then the only thing we're doing is just setting up these type of situations. Like, if we just truly were to accept that, hey, every now and then, you know, I just need to just say something hateful to somebody. I just need to bring somebody down. Like, I just need to do that. We all need to have a hate day, you know?
Do we,
hate.
Ever,
Do we ever have a day where we
Hateful Tuesdays.
Have you ever had a day where you said something nice about somebody?
Right. We pick those days.
How about Christian? That's what Christians want us to do. Christ wants us to do.
Right. Right.
Love your neighbor as I love thyself.
Right. These are all teachings. These are things that teachings. Something that we have to be taught. Right?
Yeah, start from home to parent. Hate has to be taught too. Well,
that's what you think. But when you see these, when you just hang with these kids, you know, because they
learning crap from their mama and daddy. Daddy go get drink a beer and then he go slap mama upside the head or he cussing at them. They learning that, man. Those are learned behaviors. And just like rape is a learned behavior.
And where is it not? You know, like, if it's learned, they're learning it from theirs, and they're learning it from there, and they're learning it, we're all learning this, right? Because we're like a sponge. We soak up. But at some point, we got to be held accountable for who we are.
Where's the love? Because
I know.
You can soak love up too, man.
I know, man. Where is it?
Where is it?
And you know what? What we give it to. Like, we give love to a teddy bear. We can love something that's not even real. Right? Like, love.
Because it don't hurt us.
Right? Because love.
Why do you think we people love their pets and stuff so much? Because they don't hurt us.
Because you can't control it. Like, just think about that, though. You love your pets. Like, your pet is a slave. Your pet.
No.
Your pet is born in bondage.
No.
Right?
No.
It's not supposed to be. He's not supposed to be there for you in your house waiting for you to feed it. It's supposed to be out there in the wild, like,
if he wanna
find his own food.
If he want to break camp, he can break camp.
Like, but he can't break camp because you won't let him break camp. I won't let him break camp. Like, that's the thing, man. Like, our pets that we love so much, like, they're bred in slavery. Just think about if we were not only 400 years, but like a million or 6,000 years of slavery. We were slaves for 6,000 years.
Well, slavery has been in place for that long.
No, but I'm talking about just a people, like a group.
Hold on. Let me finish. The slavery here was the most cruel and unusual slavery ever in history. No place in history where your children born into slavery because you was a slave. No time in history was that the case. In most cases, slavery was you if you owed a debt, you can pay it off and you're done. Whereas, you know, you're talking about 400 years, what's that, 40 generations, man? Into slavery and bondage. For what?
They're still slaves now.
Well, see, I ain't worried about them slaves. If they ain't rose up on their own, I can't deal with them.
But see,
if you want,
no.
But if you want to remain a slave, whether it's mental or physical, that's your doing. Okay, if everybody's gonna try to flex on you, okay, everybody's gonna try to flex on you. But it's my job to deflect your flexions. Okay, it's my job. That's what I'm supposed to do. You come at me strong, I'm gonna let you know. No, that's not how it is. If I let you do it, I'm the punk. Okay? But if I tell you it's gotta stop, you stop it. You know? It's like a battered woman. She pick up something, bust that motherfucker in the head, he'll stop putting his hands on her. She pull out her little piece and say, look, you know, first of all, she needs to just walk away from a motherfucker, because anytime a guy play slap with a woman, she's supposed to walk away from him. Because I've told my daughter, do not let a guy play rough with you, because he's testing you to see what he can do to you. Okay? They testing you to see how far they can go with you. I told my daughter, the first time a boy put his hands on you, you knee him in his nuts. Oh, I was just playing. Yep, it'll stop. If he don't want her to do it, he'll either stop or get the fuck out of her face.
Or he'll turn it up. See, like,
and then she'll tell her dad,
right?
And dad will find some place where it's a nice, quiet, safe spot for him to spend out eternity. Okay. You allow yourself to be a slave. Back then, we didn't have a choice. Now we have a choice. And that's all we're saying. Give us our rights.
So when it was us as slaves, we didn't have a choice. But those people who are slaves, the 30 million slaves that we have right now today, who this morning woke up like, man, I hate my life. They have a choice.
Yeah.
But when it was our change. Turn, we didn't have
make
a choice.
A choice. Make a change.
No, man. Slavery, like we talked about, it's a mental imprison. Like, you feel like you don't have a choice.
Oh, well, here, let me say this. To some extent, we're all still slaves because we have to go to work for money to survive. That's the way the system is set up, to profit from individuals' sweat and efforts, okay? If you paying me $1,000, so that means you making $100,000 off of what I'm doing for you. But that's how it's done. Unless I have a farm, I'm living in the woods. But give me the chance to be the best slave I can be then. if we're all slaves, don't say, well, you don't need to get an education because I want you to stay at that level. I don't want you to be a house Negro. I want you to stay your black butt in the field. Because you ashy. So we want pretty blacks in the house. You know? So, I mean, there is a form of slavery. Everybody's a slave. Even the basketball players are slaves. The rich, the multi-million dollar basketball players, they're slaves. Ask Latrell Sprewell. When he put his hands on that coach. And they fired his black ass. Ask him, is he rich now? Rich means you're not accountable to nobody, man, but God. And see, that's the thing. If more people would put their faith in God and trust in God and not seek the approval of man, they'd be a lot better off. They wouldn't be slaves. You know? Shoot. I work because I have to work, not because I work for a living. I don't live to work.
Right.
Okay? I'm working now. So I can send my baby girl to veterinary medical school. That's why I'm still working right this minute. She graduating from Cornell with a bachelor's degree and honors from Cornell University. So I'm working for a purpose. And if that's being a slave, then I'll be that slave because my baby gonna have hers.
Yeah, man. And I'm talking about, like, real slaves, the way that, you know, our people were slaves 150 years ago.
No, that don't exist, man.
Yeah, it does. It does,
you talking
man.
About black Americans or?
I'm talking about just human beings. They could be black.
In this country?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, see, we can't fight for nobody. Here's the thing. Nobody.
No, I'm just saying that it's out no, there. It's still there.
Let me say
slavery
this.
Slavery is still around.
Nobody, all these people. Talking about they civil rights. Nobody fought and died for civil rights but black people. Okay?
Black people as a whole, but because white people died. That's the only reason why we have change is because white people were out there fighting.
Alongside.
Yeah, you figured white people started the fight.
No, they didn't. No, they didn't. The black old ladies, old black lady started the fight.
All right.
What was her name? Give me a name.
Don't tell me Rosa Parks.
Yep.
Oh, no. There was several. Man, there was so many people.
That was the main event that really kicked off the civil rights movement.
That's just like music. There's always one person who embodies the style, but that person is never the best. And that we always do this. We always give whoever it is. It could be Charlie Parker. It could be Beethoven. It could be Mozart. Like, it's always one person who you know, embodies the style, who presents the style to the people.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
It's the chicken, right?
No, not necessarily.
But we know that.
No, we don't know.
If you go by the Bible, if you go by the creation story, it says that God created Adam. God created Eve, and from then, they produced kids, right? The being came first, and then the offspring came next. It, like, that's...
But I'm not talking about humans. I'm talking about chickens.
Right. It said that God created the animals, right? He created, okay. You know. He didn't say that he created, like, you know, little eggs, and then it just kind of grew up.
A chicken could have been something else before it was an egg.
Right, right. It was, you know, I believe that. Like, I do believe the evolution, right? Because that's what you're talking about. If the chicken, at some point, the new species, the change has to be defined, right? Like, if we were all of those humanoid that they find, the skeletons that they find, right? At some point, one of them has to be a human, like our modern human, right? And one of them doesn't. But if you think about it as in time, right? Mm. When you're a child or when you were an old man, right? You're still your person, even though you look different, but you're still you. So even though there's differences and you're changing, you are still you. Now, we can say, okay, you are a child, you are a baby, you are a young adult, you're middle age, you're an old man, right? But in actuality, you will always and have always been you, even though your body and everything is changing. But that does not change who you are. So, I mean, you know, I don't know. I mean, I like those type of conversations. And I understand that what I'm saying, like,
is out in left fucking motherfucking field. Yeah.
Right, right. Like, yeah, it's out of left field.
It's Stacey Dashes.
it's out of left field. And it, you know, it goes against all of the things that, you know, like all the stuff that you went through, you know, that you've seen, you know, just to say like, look, man, we're going to forget all of that. Like, we're not going to think about that. We're not going to talk about that ever again. Like, you know, that's not right to you. You want to, you know, keep talking about it.
It's
you
not
should
over
until right.
I fucking say it's over.
Right, right. You should have that right, you know? So,
you know, this one guy said, you know, somebody hit me. I feel like I got to hit him back. And that just makes us even. So I got to be one up on them. Because you should have hit me in the first place. So, you know, now there's internet bullying. Internet. You know, you can be a slave to the internet. Somebody talk about you on the internet. Then you go kill yourself. What kind of crap is that, man?
Yeah, man, I wanted to talk about stuff like that. Today, you know, just about depression and all of that, man. So eventually we will get there. But yeah, man, just I don't like, okay, when we look at the Oscars and no, like, Will Smith wasn't nominated, no blacks were nominated, you know.
Nah.
So we come up, we create our own stuff.
Well, that's what they do. They do. They have their little things, the Essence Award. She was talking about they need to get rid of that. That's what she was saying.
Right.
So if you don't want to include me, don't be angry because I do my thing too. Because we want to feel wanted and loved in some way, shape, or form too.
Right. Yeah. I mean, yeah, man. I'm with you there. I understand, like, why we're doing it. But if you continue to, that's like you. If you look at this system, you look at the game, right? You say, okay, this is the game of chess. We're playing chess. Now, you guys won't let me play. So.
Start your own league.
So we're going to start our own chess game.
Okay, here. Let me give you an analogy.
All right, hold on. Now, we're playing our own chess game, right? Now, we're playing it, but I still want you to let me play. And I'm like, all right, man, can I play? Nah, man, nah, little nigga, you can't play. All right, well, okay, man. So all little niggas, we gonna play, right? Every now and then I look over at you. Hey, man, can I play? Nah, little nigga, you can't play. All right, all right, all right. Well, we gonna play. We gonna keep playing each other, right? Now, the problem is that I want to play with those guys. That's the problem. And I can create, I can, you know, all right, I want to, we're going to play together. Me and you, we're going to play only until I can play with them. Like, nah, man, look, just forget about it. Forget about it. You don't need them to acknowledge your worth. Like, but if you know your worth, you know your worth.
That's the exact thing Stacey Dash said in opposition to. That's what BET is about. That's what the Essence Award is about. You don't have value in me. Well, we have value in each other.
Oh, but so don't complain when they don't nominate you and they don't acknowledge you. Don't complain. Like, why even say anything if that's the reason why you started playing?
Let me tell you something.
That's the only reason why me and you are playing this game, because I can't play over there, but I want to play over there. That's the problem, is that I want to play over there and that I'm not accepted. I don't feel good and complete in myself until I can play over there. That's the real problem.
You know the Wayne brothers, the ones who do scary movies?
Yeah.
You know, one of the movies made $1 billion. You think he got an award for that? He got paid. That's your reward, laughing your ass all the way to the bank. Okay? Like I said, I'm a licensed professional engineer in 2 states. Used to be 3, but 2. And I've been paid for 36 years. I don't need nobody's accolades. Just pay me. Just give me my money. My family are worshiping me and cherish me. That's all.
Right, but they just don't want their family to worship and cherish them. They want, you know, so-called, and what they're saying is that those awards, the Essence Awards and all of that stuff, don't mean anything. That's what they're saying. For you to make up a big complaint, you can say, oh, you got all the Essence Awards in the world, but how many Oscars you got?
Well.
Like, you got the best. Well, I didn't get it because I'm black.
Well, they didn't say that.
They might not. Maybe you didn't get it because you were black.
Well, it started because Will Smith didn't get a nod for the award.
Right.
For his movie.
I love Will Smith.
I love Will, too. Idris did this one movie, man. Idris didn't get a nod. You think he care? He getting paid.
Because he not from America. He
getting all the parts that...
Right, but see, they have an Oscars over in England, and I forgot the name of it because that guy who just died, the one with the crazy voice from Harry Potter, he played in some other stuff, but okay. He just died recently. Like, they were talking about how he got that award. It's like an Oscar, but it's over there, you know.
Okay.
Now I don't know if he got that award, you know, or not. I would have to look it up. But the whole idea is like, I don't care about y'all. Like, Idris, he's not American. So he's just like all the Africans that we run across. Ah, man, what y'all black Americans need to do is do this, do that. You know, you need to stop. You need to stop this.
Well, stop coming over here taking our parts. Shit. Stop coming over here qualifying as minorities and taking jobs from qualified blacks. You know? Think about that. They function as minorities. They have a whole different attitude, though. See, that's what it is.
Yeah, they have a different way. You know, like, they don't look at things the same way.
They are starting to now. What's the guy named Thunderstorm?
Oh, yeah.
He gets spit. They let him spit on him a couple more times. You out there, Thunder? I love you, bro. I love you. Get to know me first, man, before you judge me. Get to know me first. Don't judge me until you know me.
Oh, man.
I tell you what, you put your foot up in one of them asses, they won't spit on you no more. It's a mindset. They can see who they can fuck with and who they can't fuck with. You know that, though, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, man.
You know, it's how you carry yourself.
Right, and it doesn't have anything to do with skin color. It's just, look, they want to put that dick in somebody's butt. Is it going to be you, or is it going to be the next man?
But see, they feel like they're shitting their own race. but they feel good because there's one group of people that are less than them, and that's us.
I agree. I mean, we are, I would say that people feel like, all right, there's somebody worse than me.
Worse off than I am.
Right. And when you get a chance to see that that's not true, I think that really does something to that person. Like, when you have been raised to believe that, you know, hey, well, look, the black man is worse than you. But you look and you see that he's not. Like, he's really not worse than me. Like, I am worse than him. I think that really does something to him. I think, you know, like, when they realize that that's a lie, you know. Like,
well, here. What's the percentage of blacks who are educated and doing well?
I don't know.
You the host, man. You the moderator. Find that shit out.
Nah, I don't care because I don't care about that. Like, education is a joke. Like, that doesn't make you anything. That doesn't make you. It doesn't make you. It doesn't. Like, all the people that we look up to, all the people that we look up to, it's not for education. It's not because they went to a school and they got a piece of paper.
Maybe we should.
No. That's not the only way. That's not the only way of being.
What's the other way of being a success in life?
The Bill Gates way is creating something.
Everybody can't be a Bill Gates.
Right, but what?
Everybody can't be a Michael Jordan. But everybody can get an education.
But everybody can go to and get a piece of paper. Like, no, man. Like, nah. Everybody can be Michael Jordan. Everybody can be Bill Gates.
So why'd you get your bachelor's, man?
You said, why did I get it? Mm-hmm. Because I chose to get it. But people
answer my questions.
People who do not get a degree, I'm no better than them. I'm nowhere. That me having a piece of paper doesn't mean anything for far as being a musician. There are 10,000 10-year-olds who can play better than me. More than that. 10 years old. They only been on the earth for 10 years, and they can play circles around me, whip my ass on the piano. It's okay. I'm all right with that.
Do all of them have jobs?
Some of them do. Some
if
of them
you
don't.
If you didn't have your bachelor's, could you get a job?
What, teaching?
Doing what you're doing right now.
I don't even like. I hate it.
It don't matter. You
it does matter. It does matter.
See, that
because I'm paying bills.
See, it's not about
you. I can be unhappy.
It's not about you. It's about your family.
I can do something else and pay bills.
Okay.
For my family.
What else you can? What else can you do then?
Whatever. Flip burgers. I can mop floors. I can scrub the walls. What's wrong with that? What's the
ain't
difference?
Nothing wrong with it.
Nothing's wrong with it. And if that's what I like to do, if I want to mop and clean the floors and flip burgers, me do it.
I can just hear it now. If you would carry your weight, we could do so much more around here.
Hey, man. And if that's what I heard, then that's what I heard.
No, I said I could hear that now.
But all I'm saying is that at some point we have to look at, okay, what's going to make you happy? What's going to make Bo happy? Is it teaching some snotty-nosed kids?
Okay,
like,
so
is that
what,
making you happy?
What will make you happy, Bo?
I mean, I'm not worried about it. I'm not worried.
I'm asking.
Like, I see that you're trying to make it personal because.
No, I'm not.
Because
but see,
I feel like there's an attack on, you know, what you've been through. And I don't want, there's no attack. It's all valid, man. The people that came before you, the racism, like, it's real. I'm not saying that it's not real, but, you know.
I'm trying to say that at some point in life, you have to have some values to something. Whether it's just hanging out, playing video games, if that's what you want to do. But where's the responsibility part of it? Where's the responsible part of it? How are you taking care of your family? Unless you win in tournaments. Now, if you're playing chess all day and you can go whip everybody and win championships, do that. But do something that benefits your family, benefits you, uplifts you. Not just sit around and smoke weed, get high, and play video games, man. Because that's what some people want to do. And they sell a little bit of weed now and then.
Right. And that's why is that a problem?
I give up. You win. You win.
That's funny.
I give up.
I it just goes along to the point of we can't control. Like, I can't control, dude. If dude want to smoke weed and play games.
We have to control ourselves.
Right.
And if everybody controlled themselves and contributed to the system, we'd be so much better off. And I'm not talking about kissing up to or, you know, trying to please someone else. Please yourself. Don't be down on yourself. You think somebody who sits around the house miserable is happy? They're miserable. Man, if I had a job, I would do this. Or they can't see you. It's the very ones, whether they're black or white, they talk about you. Because they ain't done nothing for themselves. Okay? And they hate you because you trying. You ain't the best piano player in the world. But you trying. That's the difference. You know, don't sit back and hate. What did Jesse Jackson say to Obama?
Oh, you got to come through me.
Right.
No.
I don't think so. No, man. I mean, if he had a setback and made it, subordinated himself to Jesse, where would he be?
He'd be a senator.
He wouldn't even be. Oh, he might even lose that, man, because, you know, you lay down with mud and with pigs, mud get on you. They talking some stuff about Jesse right now.
Oh, yeah, I bet. Oh, Jesse. I think they're accusing him.
Yeah, they are.
Of being a part of the assassination.
Yeah, they are. And this ain't Caucasian. This is black people saying it.
Yeah, that wouldn't even surprise me, man.
Nothing surprised me anymore. Nothing.
Man, looking at the Black Panthers and how they had, you know, a lot of those guys were double agents in there, man. Like,
and here's the crazy thing. They would suggest, let's go rob that motherfucker over there. They would, you know, they would suggest it.
All right.
Oh, yeah, man, they robbed this thing, man. What? Yeah, man. Because, see, they're getting $300 a week to be informants. That's a lot of money back then, man.
Oh, man, I was, I forgot what I was watching. But it was talking, it was something on Netflix. I'm going to have to go in my queue. But it was talking about, it was like talking about war. And they were saying how they had soldiers, like they would have soldiers on the opposition to create issues so that people would, you know, so they would have violence. So, like, you know, let's say my gang is going against your gang, but your gang is peaceful, right? Y'all like, look, man, we can't be like that. So then I would just have plants in your gang that would cause problems so that I can shoot. And then those guys would, you know, be held up in a building or something.
Yeah.
And then we would have to do a negotiation to get them out. And, you know, it was all a ploy just to get, you know, us to shoot you. You know, and just, I mean, just think about all of those civil rights movements that ended up where people were dying in it, you know. If you know that we were rats and horrible for the Black Panthers, then you know we were rats for Martin, rats for Malcolm, you know, like.
It was rats for Malcolm. Plenty of rats. One of his bodyguards was a paid informant by the police.
Yeah, man.
I gotta find that one Make It Plain. It's on PBS. And it talks about, you know, his life, how he changed his life.
The rat or Malcolm?
Well, the rat was Malcolm's bodyguard. And Malcolm, most people didn't know Elijah. They knew Malcolm. Okay? They knew Malcolm. And James 3:16 kicked in. Because now, you know, everybody wanted to be the next in line, started hating on Malcolm. Malcolm was nothing but love, man. Malcolm was the purest form of love, because he totally subordinated himself to Elijah Muhammad. And what freaked him out was what he saw there, you know.
you know, the debauchery, the other stuff. Based on what he said. And they had the opportunity because he made a mistake. Let's kill him. Because I should be next in line. Nah, man, it was.
Yeah, man, that's crazy. Just Malcolm X. Because Farrakhan had something, like, at least he knew. He knew that this was the plan. He knew of the plan. He knew a lot of that stuff that went down.
Well, he's never admitted to that, and I don't think he would. But Farrakhan was Malcolm's protege. And I teach you everything I know, and then you turn on me.
Just like a man.
I mean, it's like your wife. It's like, not your wife, but yeah, it's like but your wife.
You teach all the ropes, how to stroke it, ride it.
No.
All right, my bad. Damn, all right, maybe the next. All right, go ahead. Let's go with you.
You're devoted, whether you're a male or female, you're devoted to that person in your life. You marry that person, whether you're male or female, and you have children with that person. And then you decide after 12, 13, 14 years with that person, you meet some stranger that you've known for a month, and they become more valuable to you than that spouse who's been dedicated to you for all those years. Now, that's harsh, man. That's harsh. That's some hard stuff, man.
Yeah.
So, you know, what? I don't know. I digressed. But
nah, I mean, you know, just setting up the relationship between Malcolm and Farrakhan for Farrakhan to, you know.
I'm in no way no expert on it. But I all I know is that Farrakhan was Malcolm's protege. And before it was all over, they had Malcolm's own brother blaspheming him. So his own brothers wouldn't even go to his funeral.
Yeah, and I know we got some listeners who are rats themselves. So I'm sure, you know, this is going to make it to Farrakhan. Look, we got love for Farrakhan, you know. I'm not trying to say, I don't know that he has information on Malcolm's killers. I'm just saying that, you know, for him to be a leader in an organization that did something like that, he would have to have some intel. It's just like when you become the president of the United States, you learn a little bit about what some of the inner workings and how things go and, you know.
We weren't criticizing Farrakhan. So
yeah. I know you rats out there already know that, you know.
We small potatoes. Farrakhan don't care about us. And besides, we haven't said anything that's not published. It's not out there in the public. I mean, yeah. We weren't there, so the only way we would know about it is from what's been published or what's been on television or this, that, or the other. Yeah. So we weren't there.
Right.
So we didn't create the story. So.
Yeah. So you rats out there, this is all just public knowledge right here.
Y'all should tell people about it so we can get some more listenership. Shit. And if you want to tell on something, you know, comment. You know.
Yeah.
Let us know how you feel. Some rat that we played somebody's music.
I know, almost a year ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a new rat. But yeah, man, I mean it's just crazy that our leaders all, and it's been, no matter how far back you go, I'm sure that, you know, it's been a rat. It's been a rat hanging out, just ready to spoil, you know, the plans.
Well, and that's the thing. People are looking for what's in a situation for them as opposed to, you know? Mm-hmm.
And it comes from, like I said, with this Oscars and the Essence Award thing, it comes from the idea that the Essence Award is not enough. So you just, you're out there and you're like, look, man, this is the big leagues. It's over there, you know, the end of what?
Well, I mean,
Major League Baseball.
Dude, Will don't need no award to validate who he is. He got his own production company, man.
Yeah, man, but they do.
No, just put the work out. Just put the work out. You know, it's about making money. It's about Denzel. How many Oscars did Denzel win?
One.
And he was for Training Day. It's for a crooked, dirty, low down, dirty cop. So. Is that what you want to win an award for? Your betrayal of a dirty, low down black cop going around extorting his own people. Think about that now, because that's what he was. He was bullied. He was extorting his own people. He was intimidating his own people. He was abusing his authority, and he wins an award for that
look
character.
Look at Halle, huh? Halle Berry. What did she get the Oscar for?
Being a tramp, slut, bitch, whore.
Yeah.
But think about it.
Yet we put value in this award.
So think about I don't put value to it because I ain't never been to an Academy Award. I don't even watch it. So, but if you think about it, those are the roles that they want to give us the Oscars for. They don't want to give us nothing for what Will just did.
Yeah. Or when he did Pursuit of Happiness, that was a good one. Will did a lot of it, man. Will did
it's
a lot
about
of
getting work. Paid, man. If you don't want to recognize me, that's fine. Just give me my money. As long as I can cash my check after the day is over, I'm happy, you know? Because mm-hmm. I can get self-fulfillment.
But see, but this is about Will not getting the nod.
But see, that's some personal shit on her part. Okay? Now, she want all the black actors to jump in. Spike, he never got an award for any of his movies. But he's going down in history as one of the great black directors. Now he did get stupid though when he talked about what's the guy's name who do Madea?
Yeah, the guy who did what?
Madea.
Oh, Tyler Perry.
Yeah, he called Tyler Perry's work buffoonery, and I'm like. You know, really, come on. You got to get past that stuff, man.
Yeah, people got to laugh, you know?
No, it's about getting paid and making money. That's what it's about. It ain't about, you know, pleasing people. You know, about what you do with your life. It's about getting paid. Hell, if they don't want to listen to our show, do we care?
Nope.
Okay, we fulfill. We ain't getting paid, but it ain't costing us nothing. That's all I'm saying. Shoot. That's what it's all about, man. It's about getting paid to take care of your family. Other than that, leave it alone.
But I think this Jada thing is causing the attention that people feel that it was needed. You know, like I think they're doing like a vote right now because the president, I want to say, is a black woman.
Okay. Hattie McDonald, she got an award.
for being a, playing as part of a slave.
Was she black or?
Yeah, Gone with the Wind. I think she was the first one to get an award or some crap like that. Let's see. Google first person, first black actor or actress to win an Academy Award. And I think it was Hattie McDaniel. She got her, she got an Oscar for her role in, and I think, as a matter of fact, I don't think she even could come in.
She couldn't even accept the award.
She couldn't accept the award that they had to present it for.
They had to take it to the back and let pick it up from there.
Yeah.
Get her speech.
Yeah.
Let's walk around back.
And the other person, was the other person was Lily of the Field. Harry about not Sidney Poitier.
Yeah, Sidney Poitier.
But look at the role he played.
Did he do Guess Who's Coming to Dinner? Did he get an Oscar for that?
No,
you know Hattie McDaniel. She's best known for her role as Mama in Gone with the Wind, which she won an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress.
Yeah, but she got one.
Making her the first African American to win.
Mm-hmm.
Hattie! Oh, Hattie! So, Hattie. So, she got. Let's see. Best Actress in the Leading Role. Okay, best actor in a leading role. Let's see, who was this? First African-American to be nominated was...
It'd been Sidney Poitier.
The Defiant Ones, Sidney Poitier.
Mm-hmm.
So he got nominated for a couple of them.
But he didn't win, but won.
He won...
Lilies of the Field.
Yeah, Lilies of the Field. And what was he in that? That was 1963.
He was like, did you see the movie Driving Miss Daisy?
Yeah.
Similar character.
Oh, man.
And the nurses. No, the maids. They
did you see Driving Miss Daisy? Oh man, they was trying to get Morgan Freeman an Oscar, huh? They was like,
I don't
man,
know. He might have got he might have got a nomination, but I don't know.
Like, look, man, you do drive Miss Daisy. Miss Daisy, you my best friend, nigga.
You gotta drive this car and shut the fuck up,
nigga. You my best friend. That's funny.
Yeah.
All right, so he was the youngest African American to win Best Actor, not only the first. I ain't gonna say it.
I mean, they don't play. You don't have black people playing leading male roles.
Oh, the Great White Hope. Earl Johnson was nominated.
Earl Jones, James Earl Jones.
Yeah, James Earl Jones.
He didn't get it.
Nah, he didn't. But he was nominated.
But you know what character he was playing, don't you? Jack Johnson. Jack Johnson.
Who was Jack Johnson? Oh, the boxer?
Yeah.
Okay.
The first black heavyweight champion.
All right. Okay, then in 72, Paul Winfield was nominated for Sounder.
And what role you think he played in that?
Okay.
Things on your head.
Oh man, was he like a slave? Well,
Sounder, he wasn't. He didn't have a leading role.
No.
Let me just say that. And in 72, they didn't have many black. They didn't have any black leading roles.
He said the Sounder. Well, I've got a song today. I'm gonna sing on it. Oh, Dexter Gordon got nominated
for.
The first musician to be nominated for Best Actor in Round Midnight. He played himself. he played Dale Turner. Who knows? Because I know that was about a saxophone player. Then Morgan Freeman, Driving Miss Daisy. He got nominated, but he didn't win it.
Oh. Just throw that dangle that carrot out there for you.
Then Denzel, Malcolm X. Nominated.
He, no, but he got his for Training Day.
Wow. And then after, so let's see.
And see, had he, see.
Oh, so Sidney Poitier, after he won, nobody won. So like, what? 99.
Who won that one?
All right, let's see.
Didn't they win one for Precious?
Yeah, I'm gonna check. All right, so the Hurricane won. So
that was Denzel Washington.
Oh, he got nominated, but he didn't win. But so Denzel won. So he
Denzel be getting him. He just
so that's what he won for. Like so after Sidney Poitier. The next person to win, the next black person to win was Denzel for Training Day.
Right.
In 99.
Right.
So that's what, like 30 years? 30 years.
Y'all need to hone y'all skills and get y'all game together.
And then Will got nominated for Ali. Oh, yep. He didn't win. And then Jamie won for Ray.
Now, Jamie was good. Jamie did his thing.
Yeah, now see, Jamie, like, his
he won,
Oscar,
didn't he?
Yeah, he won.
And he
did a good, like, it wasn't no buffoonery in his role.
No, he did Ray Charles, and yeah. he did it up. I mean, yeah. I can't complain about the character what he played, you
right.
know? You know?
Biopic.
Huh?
Said for a biopic, you know? Yeah. And then Last King of Scotland, who... Oh, Forrest Whitaker.
He didn't win, did he?
Yeah, he won.
For real? For that?
Yep.
Damn. Well, let's throw him a bone.
right. Because people felt like he should have won in the Crying Game.
I'm going to be honest. I don't think he's that great of an actor. You know, they give it to people who cannot be a leading man.
Right. That was in 2006. Oh, but Will was up for Pursuit of Happiness, but they gave it to the Last King of Scotland. He got railroaded.
Not necessarily.
Denzel was up again. He's the first for Flight, so he didn't win, but he was nominated. He has the most nominations for African-American actor.
But he's going to get paid off of that, though, man. He's going to get a Lifetime Achievement Award.
Oh, yeah. And then
Flight was a good movie, man. He played the hell out of Flight.
All right, I didn't see that.
Oh, you got to see that, man, because he was an alcoholic, man. And he flying that plane, and then something happened, and he flipped it over and flew that bad boy upside down to stabilize that plane, man.
Yeah.
You got to watch. You got to see it, man. All Flight. Right. It should be on Netflix.
Yeah. I'm gonna check. Hey, man, I got access. I'm gonna check it out. And then, 12 Years a Slave. That guy. He got nominated.
Yeah, that they don't. Unfortunately, when they nominate those type movies, those are the type movies that the roles they want us to play again. Okay, that's why the Django came out. That's why Hateful Eight.
Hateful Eight.
Did you see it yet?
Yeah.
Would you take your children to see that?
No.
Oh, man. Yeah, man. I mean, that's, you know, that's the thing. But they're putting value. They're giving value to this award, you know. And then people, like, it's like, yo, that's what I want.
Well, what they should do, you know, they should say, look. And maybe they're trying to say something. Maybe trying to say, okay, nominate some white person. For
the Essence
Award.
Yeah.
You know, for the Hip Hop Award. White people, Eminem got them.
Right.
I mean,
I'm sure he had the one of those BET Hip Hop Awards,
yeah,
or something.
You know, a white person play a good role, honor them. You know.
Right.
No, I'm not saying give up your funk, but if you know, if it's Idris versus the guy that played in it's a white guy named that played in
The Revenant, Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah. So who do you choose? They both good actors. So now if you got them going against each other, that's the to me, and you give it to DiCaprio, depending on what movie he's in, dude, you know? But they need to get in a better quality movie and stop selling themselves short right. just for a paycheck. Okay, everybody talking about Dave Chappelle is crazy for passing $50 million. Dave Chappelle refused to wear a dress. And so he gave up that kind of money. He didn't want to compromise his manhood or his marketability. So they labeled him as crazy. Now, everybody else to a person done gone drag.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Will Smith played a homosexual. Even LeBron, they had him dressed up in drag. So they try to emasculate them. They don't want them to be leading men. It falls into that miscegenation stuff. You know, they worried that white women going to fall in love with black men. You know, you want them to because every black man is not desiring a white female as their partner.
Right.
You know, I'm not going to mess with nobody's daughter. I'm happily married, you know. But if I'm an actor, give me a leading role part. I'm acting. We play acting.
Wow, but they got to give up the booty. Like, if they're acting and they're playing a scene, you know, these actors and actresses, they like to, you know, be in character.
Get a stunt double.
So they like to, you know, they like to cut it up. Like, if they're in a relationship on camera, they like to get into a small little relationship off camera.
Well, get a stunt double,
you
then.
Know. So you know, get the smash. You get the smash. You know, you get to smash that booty. Just all up in the trailer.
You know, Denzel, he never used to do a part when he was younger. He always did he always had on a T-shirt when he did a bedroom scene. You never saw his naked skin because the dude was married and he honored his wife. You know, it's.
Yeah, and he wasn't ripped up. I mean, he wasn't like shredded up, like, you know, chest just rock hard, abs just slit cut. You just cut some butter on them abs. He wasn't like that, dog.
Well, everybody can't be like that.
Yeah, I know. I think that has a little bit.
Denzel is probably one of the most prolific black actors out there.
I agree.
You know, he's gonna go down. He's been acting since 70s. He did Malcolm X before that.
Right.
But he played in this show called Saint Elsewhere.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna have to watch Malcolm X again, man, because that was the movie, man. I used to watch that movie every day when I was over here in college, man.
Uh-huh.
I would watch that movie every day.
Well, that's Spike Lee's version. I need to find that one. Make it plain. Here, let me see if I can find that on the thing. It's on PBS.
We used to watch. Oh man, Denzel, like you said, man. I mean, Denzel is just a really good actor, man. He really is, you know. And, like, that's definitely an actor that I would like to meet. You feel me? Like not meet him in the sense of, like, hey, you know, just shake his hand, I got to move along. Like, not like that type, but
hang out with him. Spend some
time. Yeah, like, you know, like, yeah, like, really, you know, meet him and really talk to him and just really just hang out and chill. And that's really probably the only Jamie Foxx, even though Jamie Foxx is a clown, man. I would
you might get your booty rod with Jamie Foxx.
Oh man. Oh, is this it?
Yep.
Okay, so this is a documentary.
Yep.
Full thing on YouTube. All
yep. right.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to grab it and then
yeah man, it's deep.
So I can
you
have
put that
it.
On DVD and get that to your kids, man.
All right.
Get that to your son or your daughter.
All right.
Hold on to that for posterity. Posterior.
All right, make it plain. Let me go ahead and put it on in here so I can remember to scoop it up.
Yeah, man. I mean, that's been done that long ago. Wow. And it gives some real insights to the Nation of Islam. I mean, they talk about it. They talk about everything that happened, man. They talked about how the FBI was infiltrating them. They talked about how the FBI fed one group of stuff you know, they had everybody hating on him. He said Malcolm X was such a was so damn straight that he didn't have no women up in his hotel and stuff. He's just devout to his to the cause, man.
Yeah, not like old Marty Marr. Marty Marr loved to travel, cause that's when he got it in, boy. He loved, man, loved going to them cities, man. Go to a new town. How much new coochie there waiting for him? Oh, Marty Marr. Not Brother Malcolm. Nah, bitch. No, I'm sorry. No, my Nubian queen. You're going to have to sit. You're going to have to go out back, okay? And you're going to have to wait out there. I'm going upstairs. Thank you, though, for this offer of delicious flesh.
I'm not interested.
But I have some flesh at home.
Yeah.
Now, Marty Marr, he in the next hotel. He'll cut it up. He'll cut you up, girl. Oh, yeah.
Who taught you to hate the color of your skin?
Yeah, Malcolm.
Who taught you to hate the texture of your hair? Who taught you to hate the shape of your nose and the shape of your lips? Who taught you to hate yourself from the top of your head to the soles of your feet? Who taught you to hate your own kind? Who taught you to hate the race that you belong to? So much so that you don't want to be around each other. No, before you come asking Mr. Muhammad, does he teach hate, you should ask
that's what it still is today.
Who taught you to hate being what God gave you?
Not to pull, I don't want him to pull it on us and start telling us we can't, man, y'all, we're going to have to pull that because you play something from PBS. See, PBS is public domain. Yeah, man, you need to pull that one down, man.
Yeah, I will.
Burn me a copy, too.
Yeah, I got
it. It's 2 hours.
Yeah. You'll be all right. Scoop that up.
Yeah, man. Because I used to give it out. I used to make copies of it and pass it out. People, watch this. You want to know something? Watch this. You know, forget about what they say in books. This is the closest thing to what you're going to get.
Man, that was the first book that I read was the autobiography of Malcolm X by Alex Haley.
Yeah.
As told to Alex Haley.
Yeah. Alex took some liberties.
Mm-hmm.
Just like he took liberties with Roots. You know, he did Root, too.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, he got sued for plagiarism. For Roots.
No, did he?
Yeah, man.
He stole somebody's story, tried to make it his grandfather's, his great-great-grandfather's.
Yep, he stole stuff out of it.
That's funny.
Yep. Well, yeah, man. Excuse me. Sorry about that. You know, it's always has been and always will be a touchy subject, race relations.
Right.
And, you know, everybody doesn't hate everybody, and everybody doesn't love everybody. And that's okay. But, you know, for me, all I want to do is be allowed to do well. You know, I've got special skills. Allow me to use them, you know. And because I want to be able to provide for my family just like everybody else do. I want my family to have all the nice things in the world just like everybody else wants for theirs. You know, we bleed red blood just like everybody else do, man. I mean, all of us ain't...
Shoot out white cum just like everybody. Just exploded on them chicks. Bam!
Wow, man. I don't know what to say about you, bro.
But no, man, in all seriousness, though, but you're right, though, man. You're right.
You know, well, I'm not trying to be right. I'm just, here. I've been around, damn.
He's going PBS?
I've been around a long time. I would remember when I was a kid and
When we got to Cincinnati, we would go to Alabama. When we got to Cincinnati, we had to get up and go to the back of the bus. I remember the water fountains that said black and white. I remember all that. Okay? I remember having to sit back at the back of the bus where everybody's smoking them nasty cigarettes. I'm a little 9-year-old, 10-year-old kid. And when the white people got through smoking their cigarettes, they went up back up front to the nice seats.
Yo, so they used to go to the back. Oh, man. They go to the back and smoke. You can only smoke in the back with the blacks. Man. Man, yeah. See, man, you've lived through it, you know?
And I understand it. I understand that everybody have level of frustration. I understand that there's a policy in place called divide and conquer. Okay? And it's just like what they did in Germany to the Jews. They have to have an enemy. They have to have a boogeyman. And right now, we the boogeyman. When with the Arab terrorist, uh-huh. It's kind of iffy, though, because, you know, because they're over here. So they linking us with them. And I don't know if they're trying to force us to become a part of the, of Muslim.
Did you hear that in Philadelphia, there was a black Muslim who shot an officer, officer in his car, and he killed him. He said it was inspired by ISIS. I guess he went over, he joined them or whatever.
You stupid black motherfucker. First of all, why you going? You don't. They use us. Those Arabs use us, just like white people use us. They use you. This one guy asked. This one guy said, "Come visit my mosque." I said, "Well, you know what? I'll think about it." And then he asked me again. I said, "Well, you know, no, I'm not interested." "Oh, what, are you scared?" I said, "No, absolutely not." "Did you have any intentions to convert me or something?" Because first of all, my Christianity is strong, and if I switched over and be a Muslim because you said I was scared, I got no faith. And would you trust me if I can convert that easily from Christianity to Islam? You know, I got nothing against Muslims, but I'm a Christian. I've been a Christian ever since I was born. I don't have to be born again because I was born into Christianity. There's a difference. And people get that twisted, too. I think the statement born again in Christ, meaning that I was born a Jew and I had to be reborn into Christdom. Well, I was born into Christdom. So I don't have to be a born again Christian because I was born into Christian. So... you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm following you.
Yeah, so they be coming up with some wild stuff. Now, you might have been a half a Christian, and you're trying to make amends. Let's do this over again. Let's do a redo. A mullet. A mulligan.
Yeah, restart. Like,
yeah. But no, man, I mean, I'm comfortable with my belief in my Lord and Savior. I mean, I got a nasty mouth, but but I'm still a work in progress, so.
Right, and there's a few. I mean, I want to say in Philadelphia, New Jersey, there are a few black Americans who converted and who are doing the ISIS.
Well, they're being used. You're a pawn. I'm just telling y'all, if y'all converting for that purpose, you're being used. You know, you can do better good here and getting educated. And I know you get tired of hearing me talk about education, bro.
But
I don't.
You know, everybody else get educated. Everybody, you know.
Right, man. I don't have a problem with you saying that, man. I know, you know, I was just saying earlier.
Oh, you just saying it for the sake of argument?
No. I was just saying that, you know, everybody, like, that doesn't change how I look at you. But hey, those of you who, if you want an education, get an education.
If you don't have a job, how are you making your money?
You said, how would I make my money?
How are you making your money? If you ain't got a job, if you ain't got an education, how are you making your money?
Me personally.
You slinging?
No, you can work jobs.
If you ain't got a job, a 9-to-5.
Right, but you can get a job without having an education.
You can get something at McDonald's.
Yeah, or
Burger King.
Applebee's. I mean, I love working at Applebee's, man. I loved it, man. I really.
So, how many women did you pick up while you was there? Because you weren't married then.
Man, I love working at Applebee's. That's all I'm going to say is that I love working at Applebee's. And if I could make any amount of money, but I had to work somewhere, Applebee's would definitely.
Did you work at Red Lobster too?
Yep, I worked both of them at the same time.
Oh, you was a Jamaican, man. You had two jobs.
Yeah, man. I stayed with three. You know,
you had three jobs.
Yeah, here.
Oh,
and,
yeah,
and working those two.
You had four then because you played the piano, man. You had four jobs.
So yeah, man. That's how I stayed like that. I worked at Walmart and Target at the same time. I worked Kaufman's. I worked all those type of jobs, man. But Applebee's. I really love that job.
You're gonna tell me off air what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Because yeah, man. See, I shouldn't even brought up Stacy Dash. It just opened up wounds and stuff.
Hey, man, but, you know, in order for these wounds to heal, we got to talk, man. We got to talk about this stuff.
We talking about somebody who can't even do hip-hop videos no more.
Yeah, but I don't think she was trying to discredit anybody who went through the struggle.
She don't know nothing about the struggle.
Right, but she's not trying to abandon black people. You know, like, I don't think that's
her. She's not my spokesman.
Right, but I don't think she was
trying
to.
That's what they were trying to use her as, a black spokesperson, and she's not.
Right, but she had a point.
No, she didn't.
She had a point. Was it a good point? Maybe not to you.
She made a statement.
Yeah, but she
ran her mouth.
She had some good grounds, man. She made some good points.
Okay, here we go again. Here we go again.
That's all I'm saying is that, you know, like, just. If you go a little bit deeper,
she's got no credibility. Let me just say that. That's all I'm going to say to it. Nobody looks to her as a credible leader in a leadership role.
We don't have any.
We do.
Who?
Obama.
All right, we got Uncle Barry. Who else?
That's enough, man.
So we got Obama.
See.
Well, he's not really
I hate to say this, but I'm going to say it. You might get mad,
but
I'm going to say it. See, my vote counted when I voted for him.
Where, like, just in Cleveland or
in
something?
In Ohio, yeah.
In Ohio.
Yep. My vote counted.
I mean.
Your vote was wasted.
All right.
Did you vote?
Yeah. Yeah, I voted.
It was wasted. Who you vote for?
Well, it doesn't matter if it was wasted, so it you know. But it's okay. Look, man, it's no big deal, man.
Cuyahoga County,
yeah, but
elected our president.
Oh, but you got Obama. He's not even a black leader right now.
See,
I think he will be, but he's not one right now.
He's the leader of the most powerful country in the world, and he happens to be black. So
I respect him for that.
Right, right.
And I, I might not agree with all his policies, you know, but that's my president.
Right, right. I mean, you know, you love him. I love Obama. I love Bill Clinton, you know. So I feel like Obama's not, he's not a black leader.
See, he don't have the leisure to do that.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, he can't be a black
Clinton
leader.
Clinton wasn't a black leader, but he did things for blacks that he can get away with doing, whereas if Obama did it, they would say he's having partial showing, but he's doing things by, you know, putting things in place
right
for everybody that we benefit from it. But everybody's benefiting from it.
Right.
But that's what affirmative action is anyway. Everybody benefits from it. If you're a female and you want to get in college, they putting you in on affirmative action too. White females, they don't think so, but they are. You know?
Man, just speaking of that, man. They was doing a piece on Hillary, man. Like, the 25% of a white woman who listens to this podcast, because I don't think we have any, but that 25% of a white woman, you need to talk to all the white women. Y'all need to join up and just grow a coochie and join your girl Hillary. Like, that's ridiculous. It's ridiculous because here she's the only woman who is running. And when you see her, you always see her around all these men. Right? So when she's dwindling in votes, like, y'all got to lift her up. You just have to.
Well,
like, come on. Have some unity.
They're looking for inclusion, but in all the wrong ways. They think the Republican Party is it because some dickhead told them, you know.
Like, it's ridiculous, man. It really is. It's ridiculous. Like, it really is ridiculous.
I mean,
like, these, like, come on. You got to support the woman. If you're a woman.
Well, here.
Support her.
Here. What's that guy named? Kane? Republican? Black Republican? He's a doctor.
Like, Ben Carson.
Okay, that's his name, Ben Carson. I wouldn't vote for him. And he black. Go ahead. I'm waiting. Go ahead.
All right. You wouldn't vote for him?
No, I wouldn't vote for him.
All right. That's cool.
No. That's because he's black? No. Fuck him.
Yeah. All right. You know.
See, he is a... he's a rich doctor.
Yeah. Yeah, so I met him in Baltimore.
You met him?
Yeah.
What'd he do? Give you a he looked up your butt or something? checked your prostate or something?
Nah. He was just, you know, hey, what's up, man? How's it going? Is everything chilling? This is when he was a surgeon, you know. So before he was running for president, and so
what you trying to do, rob him or something?
nah, man. John Hopkins is in my neighborhood. That's where, you know, that's where we hang out at, you know. All around.
So
that
how'd you know who he was? You just saw a black face look dressed up like a doctor. And so
he used to come to the schools, and because I think he's from Chicago, and he grew up in like the hood and the projects and stuff like that.
Okay, so why is he Republican?
So
how come he can't do that as a Democrat?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't like. I'm not trying to say vote for him or whatever, or you know, or you should have voted for him. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that, you know. I'm taking what you said. You said you wouldn't vote for him. That's cool. I mean, look, I'm not. Hey, y'all gotta, you know, you vote for whoever you want to vote for.
But
that's cool.
You looked at me with judgmental eyes. I'm just joking with you, bro. I ain't got nothing against the brother. It's just not. He's not the person I feel like he could hold his own and represent. Because, see, even though Obama is not our black leader, he still represents us as blacks.
Right.
You know, they don't care nothing about the fact that they got less than $2 a gallon and paying less than $2 a gallon in gas.
They don't care nothing about. He didn't get all those guys out of Iraq. You know, they just want him to. They just want to criticize for the sake of criticizing, to disarm him, to diminish his history. Okay, because you let him send some guys over there to fight ISIL, they'll have Congress try to impeach him.
Yeah,
that's all I'm saying. You know.
Yeah, I mean it's definitely. It's human nature. So that's all I'm gonna say about that, man. That's just human nature. That's the small part of the monkey that we really, I don't know. Some of my peers believe that we will move beyond that. I don't know.
We're human.
Yeah, we are.
Anyway, we can't change the moral conscience. Bo and Fig cannot change the moral conscience
right.
of the masses.
Right. And if we did, like, it's an illusion.
Yeah, I can't even change your moral conscience.
Man, but it's an illusion, man. Like, you figure for as much as we would think that how far we've come, right? Just looking at, okay, look at America, look at the consciousness of America and what is accepted and what is now not accepted. You know, if you look at that and some of you guys are saying, well, you know, there's change, like, you know, we didn't always look a certain way, but now we're you know, looking this way, and look at the that picture when those girls, when they put the nigger shirts on and they formed like Voltron and spelled nigger. If you saw how the school came together, you know, black faces, white faces, Latino faces, era, tu eres muy bonita para mí. You know,
but here's the thing. They
came together to form that unity. Look, we do not believe that these racial slurs should be out here and that we should be using it. You know, they came together.
Look, shouldn't they be able to say what they want to say?
Some would say that, yes, they should be able to say hurtful words and slogans to people. Some would say, no, they should not have the freedom to hurt other people and other groups. Look how far we've come, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time... But at the same time, man, it's an illusion. Like,
oh, that's a
it
mouth.
Can be, yeah, I know. It can be toppled, you know? Like, it can be toppled, man. And we can be right back to where we were, you know? Like, you look at Rome, and one of the things that you said that really had me just thinking, man, it was when you said that we're still in the Roman era and we're still in a holy war. You know, because we get this idea like that we're so far removed and we're not. You know, like we're not, man. Like this is, like you said, like this is still
The Roman Empire.
Like we don't see it as we're living in it, but... But this is still the Roman Empire. And this is still, and we're still fighting a holy war.
Yeah. Never ended. You see, Britain was a colony of the Romans. French, the Spanish, Italian, all of them were a part of the Roman Empire. All of Europe was a part of the Roman Empire, even the Russians were a part of the Roman Empire. And only ones weren't were the Germans. The Germans gave them hell. You know, they fought, well, let me say, not necessarily the Germans,
But those, the predecessors to the Germans, you know, those Celtics, those Celts, those type people. Not the Celtics, but those are, I think those are Irish or something like that.
Yeah.
But they fought like hell against the Germans. The Germanic tribes fought like hell against the Roman Empire. And the Roman Empire collapsed because of debauchery. And they extended themselves out too far. You know, you can conquer, but you can't, you can beat them, but you will lose out when you occupy, because you can't control the hearts and minds of individuals. And you know, they installed puppet regimes back then just like they do now. And we're a colony of the British. We're a colony of the French. We're a colony of the Spanish. So all three of those were part of the Roman Empire. So yes, we're an offshoot of the Roman Empire. And you know, it's all about money, man. You ask yourself, why were the Romans in Bethlehem? Why are we in Iraq? You know, there was the Opium War. You ever hear of the Opium War?
Yeah.
Where the British forced the Chinese to buy their opium, buy their drugs. They still do. They did it back then. So why is it so hard to believe that they won't do it now? With Contra, selling crack and selling cocaine in the black neighborhoods and then taking the money and back guns with them. Then selling the guns. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So ain't... There's nothing new under the sun.
Man, one of the things I was thinking about, man, along with those statements that you said, man, it was the fact, like, in music we study Beethoven, you know. And I was thinking about, remember, I wanted to talk about depression, you know, and just that, but looking at Beethoven, right? So Beethoven is like the 1760s, I believe.
That's going to be on your test, man. You better know that.
So he was born in 1770. And so Mozart is like the 1750s. Because he died in like 1790. Yeah, so he died 1791. He was 1750. Then Bach, well, before Bates, before Mozart, or around the same time, we have Haydn. But we keep going back. We have Bach, right? And that's usually where people, they talk about this great music, you know. Western music at its highest point, and there I just named some of the great composers.
Right.
And then let's, so we said Bach, we said Mozart, we said Beethoven. Let's end with Debussy. Debussy, let's see what's his dates. His dates, 1862. He died 1918, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, through those dates, so Bach takes us, I think he was what, 16? Yeah, 1685 is Bach, right? So mm-hmm. From 1685 all the way up to 1918, right? So there we have about 300 years.
Okay.
During the same time that you got all of that stuff going on in America, you got slavery going on. You got, so, like, as much as I think about the compositions of these great composers, right,
mm-hmm.
and the joy, like, the freedom that they had to create all of this beauty, this musical beauty that, you know, Western civilization, Western music is built on those names that I just named.
Right.
So that same time, Like, our people was oppressed heavy, like slaves.
Yep.
You know, like that's crazy because you never think of those two things at the same time. Like, you never think of Beethoven and slavery. Like, you always think of slavery and you think of whatever, but you never associate it with thing like actual at the same time that slavery was going on, the height of slavery, you know. So if we're saying 400 years, you know, the height of it is at least going to be within the 200-year point, you know, when it really is like we got this thing under control. Like, we've been doing this for 200 years.
400.
Yeah, but I'm talking about when it was 200 years.
Okay.
You know?
Just think, man.
Like, I mean, just imagine that. Like,
but when they were alive, we hadn't gotten our independence yet.
Right.
So we hadn't gotten our independence yet. So you have to look and say, okay, so our founders and leaders listened to that music while they watched their slaves out in the field working.
Who's found? Oh, like our founders.
Our founding fathers.
Yeah. Right, right. So they was listening to that music. They was watching our fathers working, mothers working, just slaves.
Yeah, man. I want you to watch this, get on YouTube and watch this one called The Rich Man's Trick. Let's see.
All right. But yeah, man, like it's crazy because right now, you know, like we're doing all this stuff. I'm working on my music. You're working on your music. We're working on this podcast. We're just doing all of this stuff. But right now, as we're doing this, somewhere in the world, you know, people are afraid for their life. You know, like, look, I don't know if I'm going to make it in the next few hours. The same time, while I'm working on this G chord, you know, seeing if I can add. Okay, let me sharp the knife. Let me flat the knife. At the same time that I'm trying to flat the knife, there's a group of people who are being shot, you know, like execution style, lining them up, just cutting heads off. And there's one guy, he's the last one in line. He didn't watch 100 people get their heads cut off. And I'm thinking, man, should I flat the knife on this one? Like, should I? Maybe I should go and sharp the fifth on this chord right here. And he's looking at the same time like, man, I'm about to die. You know, like that's just crazy that those two things exist at the same time at this day and age. You know, like it's not the 1600s, not the 1700s. No, it's right now. Nah, man, I don't need the smoke, man. I don't need the smoke, man. But think about it, man. The same, you know.
Let's take a step back. Right now, somebody's getting raped someplace. Right as we speak.
Yeah.
Right this second.
Right. Calling for help. If somebody.
And we can't come help them.
Yeah.
We don't know.
Right.
But
see, that's an individual. But we're talking about a group of people like the government and the majority of the people, what is supposed to protect you. Is hunting you down and killing you.
Well,
you know?
Yeah. But you have to realize those founding fathers were the government. And it was their prophets that they were protecting. That's what the whole thing was about. You know, they went to war with England over taxation. Give me half of your money, man.
Right.
Give me your wallet. Give me some of your money, man.
Yeah. But see,
I don't know what you put into it.
Yeah, but like that stuff is still going on in the world.
Nothing's changed.
Like,
wait. See, when you get older, you're still a young man. And when you get older, you'll be able to put things in perspective when you see them and sit back and watch different stuff. You know, take some of your experience in life that you've gone through and just keep it in perspective, man. I mean, you know. You're here for a reason. Whatever your purpose is between you and God, but you're here for a reason. And you got to fulfill it before you can move on. Okay? So, you know, I don't want to belabor that subject, but,
yeah,
you know.
But I feel like we always have 1 foot in the grave, far as like society, like this illusion that we're living in right now. This
sounds like the Matrix, don't it?
This idea of peace, like it's ready to crumble at any minute, any year, you know. Like any year.
It's always been like that.
Right.
My whole life, it's always been we're on the verge of something. If it wasn't of us with the Russians, then it was us with 9/11, it's us with the civil rights movement. It's always something. And now the greatest thing that affects you and me as black males is, you know, dealing with cops. You know? That's our great threat.
Did you see that video with the guys from Chicago that I sent you? Yeah, now I get to say it. You know, Fid always asking me if I saw that video.
I watched most of them.
I get to ask them.
Okay.
I get to ask if you seen the video.
You got me this one time, maybe. Let me see if I remember it.
It's the last thing that I sent you.
So. Oh, the guys protesting Golden Edit new video, Golden.
Yeah, like GC.
Yeah, I saw
or something.
That, man. You know, y'all ain't Black Panthers. Y'all don't even know what the Black Panther movement was about. You know, y'all ain't. They ain't scared of y'all. See, cops were scared of the Black Panthers. These guys ain't willing to die for no cause.
Right. That's the thing. Ah, you gotta be ready to bleed.
No, you shouldn't have to bleed. There's more than one way. You can't. Okay, here. If I want to make a change, I can't roll up on you with dreadlocks and a blunt hanging out my mouth. And some sandals.
Hey, little daddy.
And then roll up to you and say, man, I need some change. I need change.
Hey, little daddy, you got some change?
No, I'm talking about change. Not money, but change in the system.
Hey, little daddy, you got some change in the system.
So the best way to make change is from within, not being ostracized on the outside. You know, ain't nobody, I'm not going to give you nothing. They're not going to give you nothing. You either have to take it or absorb it. You know what I'm saying? Like anal absorption and shit. I'm not taking on anal absorption.
He said, look, man, you're going to have to absorb this.
You know, you have to become a part of it. That's what I'm trying to say.
Right.
You know, it has to be so commonplace. Once upon a time, it was uncommon to see a black person on a TV commercial. It was uncommon to see a black person on television. I remember when I saw the first black lady on television. We all criticized, man, she don't look normal. She don't look right on there.
Oh, this is the first time you saw a black woman on TV?
On a TV commercial.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Uh-huh.
And it didn't look right.
Just didn't look right. It seemed out of place.
It ain't white. It ain't right.
No, I didn't say that. She was out of place. She felt you can even tell she wasn't comfortable in her part she was playing. Now it's
yeah. You know, you just see them all the time.
Yeah, now it's commonplace, and they can sit up in the privacy of their home and slur epithets at us and not have nobody hurt. But I don't know. I don't foresee, well, let me take that back, because I didn't foresee having a black president in my lifetime. So there is possibility for change, man.
Right.
You know.
If it lines up with the money and the money makes sense, then you can see it.
Well, it's going to take something like people from another planet saying, give us your Negroes. And they're going to be like, why you want our Negroes? Just don't worry about it. Just give them to us. Nah, them's our niggas.
Somebody going to reimburse you for this nigga.
Somebody going to reimburse us for these? Well, we'll sell them to you, but
He said, somebody gonna reimburse me for this nigga.
Oh, man. You got my $500?
Now, I paid for 10 fights.
I expect 5 fights. You only gave me 3. So I want my $500.
Yeah, man, that was...
Fuck that nigga.
Yeah, man, that was a good movie, man.
What, the Django?
Yeah. Yeah, Django was a... That was a good movie.
I hope they... It'd be nice if they came out with a part 2.
Oh, what do you think? What would you see? What would you like to see in part 2? Like, him maybe going, him and his wife.
Yeah, freeing. Bounty hunting together.
Oh, all right, bounty hunting together.
Yeah, you know, just come up with another theme. She tell him, well, I was pregnant and I had a baby, and they took the baby away from me. Is it mine? You know it's yours, Django. I wouldn't be with nobody else but you. You lying ho.
Yeah, man. Part, yeah. They should.
That would be cool. They looking for her sister or a baby.
Oh, all right.
Or her or their baby that he didn't know she was pregnant with when she got sold. Right. Now, that would be cool.
Or if they get, you know, maybe a few years, 5-6 years down the road, now they got a, you know, maybe their baby was taken from them.
No, the baby was taken right when she left.
Oh, all
right. You know, that would make it, because... She had to drop it on. We had a baby.
Right.
And we got to go find it.
Yeah.
I better be quiet because Quentin Tarantino might steal that theme and go make $1 billion with
it. Nah, man, but they don't. He never had any part two, so no sequels to his movies.
Yes, he did.
Which one? Oh, Kill Bill. But he wrote that as a.
Two separate movies.
Yeah. Nah, but he wrote it in the beginning with it already being like a long, like, look, this is going to be. 2 parts to this movie. Like this story stretches out 2 parts.
Yeah.
So really it was just one movie. It wasn't a sequel. You know, it was just really just one movie. He just chose to stretch it out over 2 movies.
But he called it Kill Bill 1 and Kill Bill 2.
Right, right. But it wasn't a sequel in the true sense of a sequel.
It was a kill continuation of. It's like what you said. It was a long intermission between them.
You know, it was like, so yeah, man, but yeah, but hey, you're right though, but he did name it 1 and 2, so
yeah.
So yeah, man, there could be hope for Django Unchained.
Yeah, I had
volume 2.
She had a baby. She was pregnant when they got separated, and all the time he was gone, they took the baby, because it was more than a year before he got to her. They took the baby and sold the baby down the river to Mississippi. Now we going to go down there and get my baby.
Yeah. Big Daddy's plantation. Man, everybody know about Big Daddy's.
Big Daddy dead. The Django killed Big Daddy, remember?
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he was riding that horse. He said, come on, you got to hurry up, hurry up. I got this. Come on, come on. Boom.
Oh, all right.
When they put on the hoods and went out there looking to mess with them while they were in the camp.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. So, Lil Daddy's farm, plantation.
Yeah, you know that was a prostitute farm, don't you?
Oh, all right, yeah.
Yeah, they didn't need the, what do you call those things, fleshlights. They had real
Not everybody had access to that flesh, though. You know, somebody had to just go ahead and use their hand.
No, man, it was.
They wasn't just like, look.
It was,
man,
wild open free season.
It's come on free time, guys.
You know, you can't tell my. You got to pay me for this.
Right.
Just like Big Daddy was doing. You got to hit. You got to pay for this. Oh, no. Right.
But just like how prostitution now is.
Well, and two, you know, acceptable. Some of those women were doing it for favors with the, not just the master. But the overseers was hitting it too, because, you know, if they mess with animals, you know, sheep and stuff and pigs and stuff, you know they'll mess with. No, what's this one, man? What are those last two on the end? What are these two?
Hey, let's look at this. One of them has to be a butt. Yeah, one of them has to be an anus. And then the other one, I think it's probably like an alien. They have something where you don't even have to, like, smash coochies. You can see one hit, like, a door or I think it's something like that, maybe an ear or something like that. So, man. It really feels like a real woman. No, this isn't.
Why don't you do some research on it?
Fleshlight is an unpleasant experience. Oh, man, I had one.
You did?
Yeah, two of these. Two fleshlights. They all right. They got some other stuff, though. They got all kinds of crazy stuff.
Well, I don't know what to say, bro.
Yeah. Man, they got dolls. Whole.
Yeah.
Fleshy type of, you know, like big.
Yeah, that'd be cool,
human
man.
Size.
Put her in bed with you.
Yeah. Yep, yeah.
Run some heat through her.
Right, they had, I want to say they had an Asian guy. He had a whole bunch of them. They was like maybe 15,000 per doll or something.
Yeah, they got that etched out. That's exactly what that one is, the second to the last one is.
Mm-hmm. You think it's the anus? That's what I think it is.
Now, what's the last one?
That, I don't know. Hopefully it's not like an underage.
No. I know they ain't doing no crap with that, man.
Oh, man.
Somebody looking to go to jail where they start playing with that kind of stuff, man. No, for real. And they would put you in jail so quick, man. It's pathetic.
If you had an underage fleshlight.
Just the idea of suggesting that, man.
Right.
You can't play like that, man.
Right, man. Like, that's so... Like, that is crazy. Like, you think about it, man, because the virtual, like, with, what is it called? Project Morpheus, and Sony has one. So, like, these virtual headsets and goggles and all that stuff is going to be available soon. Yeah. Some of them are available now, so.
Any way to get your money.
So, eventually, porn will seep into this. We talk about this a little bit. Eventually, porn will seep into this market, right? You get you that, you put the headset on, you have a virtual chick, you get your fleshlight, you ready to rock and roll, you know? She rides, since she, like, as you put, you control her body with the fleshlight. So as you...
So you got to have a fleshlight hooked up to the system.
Nah, the way it'll be, because this thing can track, it can track the things that's in your room. So it'll see the fleshlight. So when you...
But again, you want a response from the fleshlight.
Right.
You want it to react to you.
No, well, the fleshlight is just going to be the fleshlight.
No, see, but you staying low tech. I'm trying to go high tech with it.
All right.
You want it to react to your action. You want it to simulate having an orgasm.
So you want it like shoot out on you or something.
You want it to do something on you, and then you do something back into it.
Nah, but see, that's going to be too long. We talking about tomorrow.
No, that can be done tomorrow, man. They can do anything they want to. They can send a man to the moon.
That hasn't been proven, man. That's not real.
What?
That they sent a man to the moon.
Okay.
On to the fleshlight.
Okay. I'm tired of arguing with you tonight.
I'm just messing with you, Finn, with the man on the moon, man. I'm just messing with you. But with the fleshlight, though, right?
Yeah.
Boom. Now you can just have sex with this virtual girl, right? Now, when they do the underage virtual girl, should the guy go to jail?
Yes. Because you're pandering. It's not a real minor. But you're creating a climate for, because you can do it virtually, then why not? Well, damn, how come I can't do it for real?
So should the programmer, should he go to jail too for creating this underage program?
Well, let me ask you. You go to a head shop. Do they still allow head shops?
What's that, a head shop?
Damn. paraphernalia for getting high with, man. So,
like a shop, and you can buy
bongs.
Oh, all right, stuff like that.
It's called them heads. They used to call them heads.
They probably still have them. I just because I don't get high. I don't know.
I don't get high either, but I just
right
know about stuff, man.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
Just because I'm in it, don't mean I'm of it.
Right.
You know. Mm. But yeah, what is the intent for the head shops, for the bongs, for the pipes?
So should they go to jail? I was saying no, but you're saying maybe they should because they're...
They're pandering. They're selling products to get high off of. Should they be allowed to do that? Should you sell junkie needles?
Yeah, I mean, if people want to buy needles, then you can...
You got to have a prescription to get them.
Oh, you got to have a prescription to get a needle. Well, not anymore, right? Because they have them where you can just go and get needles and stuff. Like, they have, like, a needle exchange where they can...
Those are special programs for well-established druggies. But they doing it through a prescription. Okay, here's another one. I'm a crook, and I want to break into houses. I got a felony. Should I be allowed to become a locksmith? Okay. Uh-huh. I mean, really, should I be?
I like that one.
Okay, that's a good one, huh? Damn, I got one tonight.
Oh, man, you always come up with the good ones, man. That's funny. Yeah, man, you should be allowed.
What, to be a locksmith?
Yeah, like, that's crazy for us to be like, nah, man, you can't be a locksmith.
Most criminals just kick punch the door in anyway. You know how easy it is to get? I could get into any lock. I don't care how good it is. In 10 seconds. I'll tell you offline how you do it. Okay?
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure they beat with YouTube. I'm sure it's up on YouTube.
I don't know. I haven't looked, but I used to put locks in. I used to do work for CMHA. I had a contractor's license. And I used to have to change the locks, you know, and change the doorknobs and everything. Shit, all I would do is buy that core, change the core out, polish the lock back up, charge them for a new lock.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Yeah. But,
we're up on what?
2 hours and 22 minutes.
All right. Yeah, man, we call it a wrap right here, man. All so, right. Here we are. You guys know what time it was. We had some good discussions, good topics. So, now it's only to say, who are we brought to you by? Well, we didn't videocast this episode, but don't worry. We'll get into it because of the storm. Whatever excuse you guys want to think about, but eventually we'll do that. It's the technology is there. It's more of the location. So once we figure that out, we'll be video casting more consistent. So be on the lookout for that. Anyway, we're brought to you by BoKnowsMusic.com. Go there, pick up, sign up, create the free account. All right. Even if you don't want to learn piano, you're like, man, but I don't even want to learn how to play the piano. Go there anyway, all right? You cocksuckers, go to Bono's Music and freaking sign up. Create a free account today. Also, fidlu.com. Go there, pick up an axe, learn the bass, and give back. Give back to the next musician who wants to learn the bass. You can say, you know what? I got this from the legend. Fidlu himself touched this axe right here. How can you go? How can you get an axe from the legend? You go to fidlu.com and you buy it today. Last but definitely not least, Weebly.com. Create your online presence with Weebly. You don't have to pay. It's free. And then once you feel like, okay, this is what I want to do, you can go ahead and throw down a couple dollars and make it official. Weebly.com. And we are out.
Peace.
Shorty's a trapper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go.
What, man?
Shorty's a trapper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Always asking who was the blame. Never asking, can my niggas be saved?
Story was about me. I guess I'll tell you about my dad, my real father. I didn't know, so I was lucky to have the kind of dad with integrity that knew one day that life ill surely would come for me. And they did. His only blood child was alive on the other side of town. It's hard to know how she felt because she hardly came around. Maybe she was mad at her daddy. He's here with me, not with her, where he's supposed to be. Feel me? But daddy had a couple secrets of his own. Working up in them schools, couldn't leave those young girls alone. Now the rumors started catching up. What they say, said your child a little something, something. She's in the fifth grade. After job was classic. Used the strength from my mom, but couldn't beat that sexual harassment. I guess it was an addiction of some sort you couldn't shake. That kept coming back, eating food off our plates.
Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow? No. Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trapper now. Could he be saved somehow? You know. Always asking who was the blame. Never asking can my niggas be saved.
Now if the story was about me, I guess I'd tell you about school. I used to go every day. That's what my mom made me do. I gotta admit that I was good at first. In third grade, before you knew it, I became the worst. Who could say I still went every day? But my mind wasn't there. Started falling behind, but really, who fucking cared? Not the teacher, she just wanted the kids to greet her. Say good morning, Mrs. Williams, in the afternoon when you leave her. A real bona fide diva. I failed that year, I should have failed the next, but I would have been bigger than the other kids. All of a sudden, I'm not like all the other kids. My best friend's moving on, I gotta start again. I see school ain't for me, I just let time pass. The teachers never tried to help, they just let me pass. Only a matter of time before I drop out, man. They say they need more money. With a cop out.
Shorty's a trapper now. Could he be saved somehow, you know? Now he's at the end of the road. My little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trapper now. Can he be saved somehow, you know? Always asking who's to blame. Never asking.
If this story was about me, I guess I'd tell you about Keem. He was the man on the block, the black American dream. Fly leather coats and butter Timbs, what he sport in. Before they even had the streets, he had them Jordans. Remember looking up to him like a big brother. Always had a lot of cash, had to be good with numbers. Never pen and paper. Kept everything in his head, a cherry red Benz with no registration. They say you live by the gun, you gon' die by it. And if you laugh in the hood, you gon' cry by it. A real nigga got killed just the other day. Didn't even make the news, but what could they say? A child hero's gone, somebody talk to him. I could see his soul as it walked through him, telling me to stop. turn around and run away before another kid sings a song another day. Shorty's a trooper now, can he be saved somehow? No, now he's at the end of the road, my little nigga's got nowhere to go. Shorty's a trooper now, can he be saved somehow? You know, always asking who is to blame.